I'm the doctor. I remember
when. Oh yeah.
Well,
I'm a doctor.
Where do I make the D&D character? Where is D&D.com when you need it? Ranger, sorcerer, wizard. Ranger is the worst class. I think all you get is an animal companion. I love Ranger.
Okay, he's Ranger. Because I would say he's the British accent, except he's French.
He's not always. The British accent comes during periods of brief lucidity.
Hey Caleb, you wanna get branded?
No. Kyle, I guess we'll explain what happened last night. We met our boss. Robert keeps claiming to know, like, the boss.
I do know the boss.
And then gets, like, all right, baby, the details wrong. The only thing you know is Tuesdays.
I know Charlie.
The boss leads us to this room and then he just like dips out because he's got like important paperwork to do. And then he hands us off to like his unicorn supervisor. And the unicorn supervisor's got busy shit to do. So the unicorn supervisor just like go down the hall. You'll find someone who will actually help you. We go down the hall and we find a sex dungeon. That apparently Robert is familiar with.
I was! On Tuesday!
He was.
Even Jason even rolled an insight check to make sure I wasn't bullshitting about that.
He definitely knows this place. We then jump down a trash chute. First assignment is apparently to clean out the basement. And we go down the basement. We see a rat and we're like, Kyle!
Oh shit! A rat!
Robert tries to attack the rat several times and fails.
Look, I hate the worst rolls ever.
Alex's instinct is always to run away.
Even then, at first.
He's just like, I want to get to the end of the room.
Also, Alex is now in a gimp suit.
Alex didn't have any clothes, so he got dressed in a gimp suit.
But it wasn't Tuesday for him.
It wasn't Tuesday. Also, pretty good armor stats on the gimp suit.
Yeah, it's higher than my armor.
It's higher than Robert's armor class.
And Jason's.
It's on par with mine, I think. We slay some rats, and we finally actually like start collaborating together. And we find a giant ass toad.
And I make the fight of a lifetime. Jason has been captured by the beast.
The toad has Jason in its mouth.
Brilliant idea to put the toad to sleep.
With a high chance that Jason could also be put to sleep while he's in the toad's mouth.
Yes. So I calculated it all, so I knew it wasn't gonna happen. I knew.
And luckily it didn't happen. We put the beast to sleep and we kill the toad. And then zombies crawl out of the toad.
Yeah, it was my best friends, my two best friends. The halfling girl who's absolutely terrified of me and the drug dealer.
All this is happening while I'm holding cat shit.
Yeah, Caleb is reading
because
cat
I thought it would be a good idea to fight the rats with cat shit. The rats didn't attack me once. And you know what? You weren't holding the rat shits. That's why. The cat shits.
It's true.
I like the biggest zombie skeleton on fire. fucking Robert is now haunted for an hour by his mother with the voice of his father. And it all sounds incoherent when we say it like that, but trust me.
Alright. So, what actually happened? Caleb has his own theory of what happened, but I'll tell you how it is. Alex, we started out the dungeon. Alex falls down. He's, like, crying, being a little bitch, so he runs out of the room. There's, like, 10 rats, by the way, and the huge-ass toad. So, and then Drew goes down to all the rats, because he's getting nibbled on, and Drew can't take it. Jason gets swept up by the rat, by the toad. He's being chomped on. Caleb is busy covering himself in...
myself and cat shit. Then I put Jason to sleep in the toad.
Skeletal ogre.
Robert tried to brand the hobbit twice. It clearly got eaten by the toad.
Toad unfortunately got my best friend.
Robert, you never touched the skeleton ogre. You were trapped by a rat.
That's what happened. And then my story was better, right, Kyle? And more believable.
The story was better, not believable.
Also, everyone got branded at the end.
No one was branded. He's asked every character so far if they want to be branded. None of them have been branded. Even Alex, before the session, was like, I'll get branded. During the session, he's like, no, I'm not getting branded.
Yeah, I don't understand why he changed his mind.
He changed his mind because he figured out that branding is like a metal rod. At a high temperature. I don't know what he thought it was. He probably thought it was a tattoo.